Hey everyone, welcome to our top 10 list, and here's my top 10 best animes of 2015. Yes, I looked over the year and I thought, I don't think I can make a top 10 best animes of 2015, because I don't think I've watched enough anime. I watch a lot of anime, just not enough, because I watch a lot of shows, and a lot of movies, and a lot of other things. But as I realized, as I count, I'm like, yeah, actually, I can make a top 10 best. I have watched enough anime to make a top 10 best or favorite animes of the year. So, yeah, I thought I'd do this a little early because I'm doing my top 10 best and worst movies of 2015 in a few weeks. Then I'm doing my top 10 best TV shows of 2015. Then I'm doing my top 10 most anticipated movies of 2016. So, I have a lot of top 10 lists I gotta get through. So, I'm gonna do the animes first. And, yeah, let's get started. Here's my top 10 personal favorite or top 10 best animes of 2015. Alright, coming at number 10 is Dragon Ball Super. Yes. Everybody should know that I'm a Dragon Ball Z fan. I love Dragon Ball Z. I even love the original Dragon Ball TV series, but Dragon Ball Z was always my favorite. I love the Dragon Ball Z movies, and I love all the characters, and I just love how badass it is. See, Dragon Ball Super actually takes place during the time zone of, like, the new Dragon Ball Z movies, you know, like Battle of Gods and Resurrection F. It's between Dragon Ball Z and Dragon Ball GT. I think that's not GT, because GT sucks, but yeah, that's what Dragon Ball Super takes place in, and I really like this story so far. I like how it's going, I like where it's going, and I enjoy all the characters. All my favorite Dragon Ball Z characters are back. I love Goku, I love Vegeta, I love Trunks, I love Goten, I love Gohan, and they got Beerus in this, and Beerus is great. All your characters that you love in Dragon Ball Z are in this show, and they're all great. The action's awesome, the animation's good for what it is, it's badass, it's one of my favorite animes of 2015. Dragon Ball Super, awesome. Coming number 9 is Food Wars. Yes, Food Wars. I was actually introduced to this anime by a friend. He said, you'll love it because you love movies about food. Yes, I do love movies about food, like Bert, Chef, and Ratatouille, but I never really watched an anime about food. I think there is a bunch of animes about cooking and stuff, but Food Wars is actually, I think, the first anime I've watched about cooking, and I freaking loved it. I loved this show. This show was great. I love how silly and over the top and how serious they take cooking. It's just great. It's awesome to watch. Pretty much the story of this anime is about a guy. He wants to become the owner of his dad's restaurant. His dad is like the best chef, and this guy wants to be the best chef. But unfortunately, his dad closes the restaurant for a couple years, and he has to go to a school. And yeah, I loved this anime. It's so silly. It's so over the top, but I fucking love it. I love the comedy. I love the characters. The actual animated TV show made me hungry. I was hungry at the end of each episode. I wanted all this food these characters were cooking. It was just delightful and delicious. It's just awesome. Food Wars, one of the best animes of 2015. Coming number 8 is Gangsta. Yes. Gangsta. Yes, I really liked Gangsta. My sister actually showed me this anime, Gangsta. I think it was on her top 10 another anime list. I didn't watch it yet, but I just recently watched it like a month ago. It's really good. The English dub was a little better than the English sub. That's an opinion. I love the characters. I love how gritty and violent this is. It's a very bloody, very disturbing graphic show, but it's really good. It's very compelling. It's got some great drama. There's some very scary imagery in this anime, and it's decently designed, and it just keeps you on the edge of your seat at the end of each episode, and it's just a great anime. Great action, great thrills, great scares, and some great drama. Very compelling and very great anime. So, of course, it had to make the best of 2015. Of course. Coming number 7 is it wrong to pick up girls in a dungeon? Probably, but this guy does it. Yes, this is a strange title. Is it wrong to pick up girls in a dungeon? That title alone sold me. Like, that sounds like a great anime. It sounds like an awesome title. I'm in. And I watched it in one day, and this anime was great. Not only was it funny, not only was it beautifully animated, but it was really dark at times and very unpleasant at times. And I was just so involved with these characters. I was so involved with the world. The world of this anime is just beautiful and awesome and just interesting. And by the end of it all, you'll want to know more. Trust me. When each episode ends, you just want to know what happens in the next one, in the next one, in the next one. And by the end of this all, you're like, what's going to happen next? And you don't know. You don't know. And I'm not going to spoil anything about this anime. Just watch it. It's funny. It's action-packed. It's visually stunning. And just, it's a great anime. Entertaining from start to finish, most definitely. Coming number 6 is Gate. Yes, this is an anime I just watched a few weeks ago, and it's a great anime. Again, it's a war anime. I've seen a few war military kind of animes. This is one of the best ones. It's really solid. Like, I love a good military kind of ops anime, and this is very well done. It's, again, very realistic, and it's very fast-paced, and it's just so well done. The animation's very good. It's very dark. Like, even just the world this anime takes place in, it's a very dark, very bleak, and gloomy kind of anime. And characters are interesting, the story's interesting, and it's entertaining from start to finish, like many other animes on this list, but Gate just really had my attention, and again, I marathoned in one day. It's a phenomenal anime. Check it out if you've not seen it. Gate, awesome. Coming number 5 is Noragami Season 2. Yes, I love Noragami. The first season of Noragami just got me hooked. I loved it. I loved the comedy. I loved its premise and its action. I loved how sad it can be at times. Season 2 is just as good, if not better, than Season 1. It's got all that same stuff. There's sad scenes. There's some really sad things that happen in Season 2. There's some really dark things. But there's also some freaking hilarious things. It's just so funny. Both of my favorite characters from the show are back. Yukine, Yato, I love them. I love them two together. Great. All the characters from the first season are back. They're great. They're awesome. All I wanted from Noragami Season 2 is for it to be just as good as the first season. And it accomplished that. It's just as good, maybe if not better. I'm probably going to have to watch it a few more times, but first season just, I loved so much. This one I did too. I might have to watch it a few more times, but as of watching it only once, it's fantastic, just as good as the first season, and it's my 5th favorite anime of 2015. Coming number 4 is Fate Stay Night Unlimited Blade Works. I mentioned this in my top 10 another anime's list with my sister. I went to more depths about it, so if you wanted me to go into more depths about Fate Stay Night Unlimited Blade Works, me and her both talked about it on and on and on for about 10 minutes, so yeah, go watch that video. But as a short little review, it's a great anime. I loved it. I'm a big fan of Fate Zero. Fate Zero is one of my favorite animes. Unlimited Blade Works is almost as good as Fate Zero. Fate Zero is a little better, but Unlimited Blade Works was awesome, because I'm not the biggest fan of Fate Stay Night. Fate Stay Night has some good stuff in it, but this anime was much better. It did Fate Stay Night, it did it better. Fate Stay Night Unlimited Blade Works has better action, better characters, better visuals, better style, better designs, better atmosphere, just better everything. Unlimited Blade Works is just a great, great story. I love the story of all these people fighting for the Holy Grail, and they have these servants. They're all historical characters, and it's just so awesome. The action in this anime is probably some of the best action in any anime this year. It's phenomenal. Some of the visuals are just amazing. It's breathtaking. The designs are so good. There's a lot of heart and a lot of emotion in this anime. There's a lot of dark moments, too. There's some characters from Fate Zero in this anime, and if you like certain characters of Fate Zero, you'll be very pleased with this anime, and you'll be very pleased of what they do in this anime. That's all I can sort of say. The two lead characters make the show. They're very good. I love their chemistry with each other, and I buy their romance in a way. I love that they brought Saber back. Saber was always my favorite servant. She's badass. She's awesome. Come on, she's King Arthur. That's fucking great, and it's awesome. I love that they got Hercules in this. That's so cool, and I don't want to spoil all the servants, so I'm just going to keep my mouth shut, but yeah. You gotta watch it. Some characters from Fate Zero are in this, and you'll love that they're in this if you like their characters in Fate Zero. And again, I don't want to spoil it. The action's amazing. The animation's amazing. There's some great atmosphere, great dark moments. It ends perfectly. It begins perfectly. And it's beautifully paced and beautifully well done and beautifully executed. Just a great anime. One of my favorites of 2015. Coming number 3 is One Punch Man. Yes, One Punch Man. Yes, I loved this anime. My brother introduced me to this anime a few weeks ago, and I was freaking hooked. I don't think the anime is done right now. No, it's on episode 11, I think, as of now. Episode 11, yes. This anime is phenomenal. It is so freaking funny. There's some great action, like Dragon Ball Z sort of action. But it's mostly a comedy. If you treat it as a comedy, not just as an action, because if you're just looking for an action anime, this might disappoint you, but if you're looking for a good comedy with action in it, you will adore this anime. This anime is one of the best animes of the year. This anime was so funny. It's about basically a guy, he has a power, and his powers are so strong, he can kill you with one punch. And everyone doesn't know how he did it. You still have no idea how he had this power and how he got this power. It's just awesome. He just wants to become a superhero. He wants people to love him. The two lead characters are probably the best characters. And I love how they do superheroes in this world in One Punch Man. I love how they all have ranks and everything. It's just so funny. How they do superheroes in this world is just awesome. And I love all the different kinds of superheroes they have in this anime. It's really funny. Really enjoyable. There is some great comedy in this anime. Oh. And as of now, as of episode 11 just ended, I just really want to know how this anime is going to end, because it's just, I'm excited for it. I'm just, every time an episode ends, I want to watch the next episode because it's just so funny and just so entertaining. One Punch Man is definitely one of the best animes of this year. It's so good. Great action, great characters, great comedy. It's awesome. One Punch Man. Push. Coming number two is Death Parade. Yes, again, another anime I mentioned in my another anime list. This anime was so freaking good. I've watched this anime multiple times, I'd say about three times. It's so good. I love the story of purgatory. People have to go to purgatory and they have to play a game, and this game will decide whether you're going to hell or you're going back to Earth as reincarnation. And that idea is just so clever. I love the premise of this anime. It's so freaking awesome. I love the characters. All the characters are great, and it's just so amazing. Oh my god, I can't spoil this. I can't spoil what happens to all these characters because that will just ruin the anime. It's just an amazing anime. It's awesome. It's awesome. And don't think of it as just Saw. Like, I know you're probably thinking, oh, they play games so they can live or not? That sounds like Jigsaw. It is not. It is not. I can't say why. When you learn about these characters and what they have to go through in these games, like, there's one story I love about this boy and girl, and they have to do bowling with each other, and they used to know each other on Earth. That story is just, it's very precious, and it's very adorable and very heartwarming. And there's another great story with a girl and a pop star, another great story, but my favorite one is when a girl and a guy have to play an arcade game together. That's all I'm going to say. If you've seen this anime, you know what episode I'm talking about. This anime involves, like, murder and a little bit of suicide and drugs and stuff. I don't want to spoil it, but, like, I think I'm spoiling too much already, but the characters in this anime are really good. It's very dark. It's not a happy anime. Again, it's not like a slice-of-life anime. It's a very dark anime. But it's got such a unique premise, great characters, amazing stories. You will cry, you will laugh at times, and most importantly, you'll be engaged from start to finish. It's so engaging, so gripping, and just amazing, mesmerizing, this anime. Death Parade, definitely one of the best animes of 2015. And my number one favorite anime of 2015, or what I think is the best anime of 2015, that is Charlotte. Charlotte, oh my god. This anime is like Angel Beats. Yes, Angel Beats is like my third favorite anime of all time, and Charlotte is just as good as Angel Beats. Angel Beats is probably a little bit better, but after I watched Charlotte, this anime is now probably my top 10, maybe my top 5 favorite animes of all time. This anime is amazing. It's just so freaking good. Again, like Death Parade, I don't want to spoil this anime. I don't want to spoil anything in this video. You just gotta watch these animes. Just watch all these 10 animes at the end of this video. Just watch them all. Even if it takes weeks, just watch them all. But Charlotte is so good. Like, it's about basically a guy with a gift. He has an ability to possess other people, and basically these other students, high school students, find him, and they basically tell him to go to their school, and it's a school with other people that have gifts like that. They have special gifts, like powers, almost like superpowers, I guess you could say. They're almost like mutants and stuff, and basically they're trying to hide from people or trying to experiment on them and everything, and basically their job, basically it's their job to find other students in this city that have other powers so they can help them, rescue them, and help them deal with their powers and stuff. And these powers don't last forever. They run out when they reach adulthood and stuff. And that's, I think, all I can say about this anime, because I'm not going to spoil the ending. I'm not going to spoil what happens in the story, because it's sad as shit. Like, yeah, there were some really sad moments. This anime did remind me a lot of Angel Beats, mostly with its tone and characters. Yeah, like, Angel Beats does have a different story, but between its characters and its story, it kind of have the Angel Beats sort of feel. Like, it's very, very funny, but it can get really, really sad at times, and there's a lot of sad moments in Charlotte. It's so good, though. The animation is just gorgeous. Sort of like the Angel Beats sort of style animation, which is beautiful. The animation was gorgeous. Just stunning. One of the most beautifully animated shows of this year. So good. The characters are all amazing. All of them. They're all good. There's not a single bad character in this show, like Angel Beats. It's just so good. I love the characters. It's so beautifully written. So well executed. So well structured. The story is just beautifully told. The animation's top-notch. Everything about this anime was done perfectly well. It's amazing. Charlotte is hands down the best anime of 2015, and it's my favorite anime of 2015. So yeah, that was my top 10 best animes of 2015. So yeah, in the comment section below, please tell me, did you agree with this list? If not, give me your top 10 favorites. What is your favorite animes of 2015. Give me your top 10s. Comment below and let me know. And as always, if you like this video, please like and subscribe to this channel and join the dark side.